song for the broken hearted.
Listenerland, this is Melissa Bryan, the one, only, and original Outlaw Psychic from Umpqua Valley Psychic and Media, the Outlaw Psychic LLC in Roseburg, Oregon. I apologize for the tech difficulties we were having yesterday. I know everything sounded a little wonky, but I'm test trying out a brand new microphone, and it is a boom set mic. This is one like a professional recording studio would use. And so far, everything sounds and looks really good, and I'm very pleased with it. Thank you to Wish.com for allowing me to order this, and I'm really happy with it. I'm thrilled. This is making my show sound so much better than my other headset mic did, and I'm really, really loving this new experience. This is great. It sounds good. It feels good. You know, I'm just really happy with the new sound. And of course, no, I was not having a stroke yesterday. I was having technical difficulties. Apparently, my headset boom mic thing went out on me, and I was not able to replace it, so I knew I had this sitting around. I wanted to try it anyway, so I put it together with the help of my hubby, and so far, so good. Everything sounds really wonderful. Thank you to Wish. Right on. This new boom mic works fantastically now. And luckily, I don't need my sound mixer for the meantime. And eventually, when I can get myself a tripod, I may even put this show on video. How cool would that be? And so, this is just a test, and to see how this sounds. I hope it sounds really good, and so far, so good. I love this. Little one. Oh, yeah, sorry, my cats. They're being little brats this morning. Oh, well, what can you do with new kittens, right? Oh, my heavens, my heavens, my heavens. So, anyway, now it sounds like a professional recording studio does. Yay! Finally, right? At least I don't sound all wonky and all weird and all that shit. Yeah. just look. All the lies and all the bullshit against me needs to stop. Okay, I had a victory with Yelp today, this morning. I got notified that the false report against me got removed. Good. About damn time. Now, I just need to find out how to get Ripoff Report and all these other fake and false reports removed. I may contact 8chan right now, the next step over, and get them to remove the page against me. I don't care what free speech says. Free speech stops, okay, when it discriminates against someone for being themselves. Okay? That's what it does. Oh, dear. This thing here is coming off. Hang on, folks. God damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it. Fucking damn it. Now I gotta put this back on. God damn it. God damn it, god damn it, god damn it, god damn it, god damn it. Here, put that back on, dear. If you can. Screwed on there good. There we go. Sorry about that, folks. Just my little windscreen is not exactly cooperating with me right now, but hey, this at least feels like a professional radio studio, and I'm really loving the sound. So bear with me as I get used to this new system and new sound system, new microphone and all that. Hopefully I can get my headphones to work with this so that I can hear what I'm saying and doing. But anyway, all the lies, all the bullshit, all the hate pages and all that need to be removed. If they are not removed immediately, I will turn to my attorney to get those removed. And I will get them physically removed. Yes, I will. Don't underestimate me. Never, ever underestimate me, because I will get this removed. I am not going to put up with it. It is all bullshit, and it needs to stop, all of it. And I mean that. I mean that very sincerely. Think I won't? Try me. Yeah, you heard me right. Try me. And I've caught this individual sneaking onto my social pages to steal my information, to use it in false advertising against me. And I have caught someone sneaking around my trailer, although I don't know who this individual is. I know it's not the main player. It is an operative of whoever is behind this. Okay? I found a note on my bed that just came out of nowhere that apparently was in my husband's stuff or slipped in there somehow, that sent the same messages as all the text messages, emails, phone calls, and all the bullshit that's been going on. Well, guess what? We're not putting up with it. I'm seeking legal redress. I'm not kidding. I'm going to an attorney. Try me. You think I'm lying? Try me. I'm dead serious. This is not going on anymore. I'm not going to allow it. Forget it. But, in the meantime, for right now, I'm just getting my shit out of the way for the day, getting stuff done. I've got a lot to do today, and I've got to get my shit done. I don't have time to sit around here and wait. You know, I'm not going to spend my days fighting and fighting and fighting and fighting over my rights to my life. Because you know what? My rights to my life are my rights to my life, not anyone else's rights to my life. And I'm not going to allow this to continue. This is bullshit. Go ahead, try me. I don't care. Fuck you. Damn windscreen, stay put. God damn you, stop. Damn it. Sorry, my windscreen's not exactly staying put. I have to figure out a way to do that. But, you know, the fake messages, the text messages, all that shit, it's got to stop. And I mean dead stop. And I'm going to go after you with a goddamn fucking vengeance. You understand me? I really am. I'm going to go after you with a goddamn fucking vengeance. Don't think I will. Try me. So, I really love this new sound system. It sounds good, it looks good, it feels good, and it's really making this show come out a lot better than my last ones. I just wish I didn't have to hold on to it with one hand. This is not supposed to be where I have to hold on to it with one hand. In fact, I'm supposed to be able to go hands-free to do other things with my show. Oh, well, I'll get used to it. I'll work it out. I'll figure it out to where it feels right and to where I don't have to worry about this thing constantly, you know, not staying put. Which I think I have to put something underneath of this to make it stay put. God damn it. Stop. Stay put. Damn it. God damn it. There. Maybe now it'll stay put. Nope. No, fucking goddamn it all to hell. Fucking goddamn it all to hell. I'm gonna fucking make the thing stay fucking put if it's the last fucking thing I do. God fucking damn it. Alright, you stupid motherfucker, you're gonna stay put like it or not. I have to do this myself, apparently. Or do this the right way. No, that broke. Oh, great. Fucking goddamn wonderful. This just broke. God damn it all to hell. God damn it, why can't my life go right for once? You know? This thing will not stay put. No matter what I want, no matter how hard I work, no matter how hard I try. Nope, fucking nope. Great, this little whack job thing just fucking broke on me. Come on, you motherfucker. Come on. God damn it. This little whack job screen thing just fucking broke on me. God damn it all to hell. Fuck you, you motherfucker. Whack job windscreen. No, it won't work. God damn it. Oh, fuck it. I just fucking threw it across the room. I don't care anymore. Fuck it all to hell, you know? Fuck me and my life all to hell. My life fucking sucks. That's the way my fucking life goes. Everything I try to do breaks. Everything I try to do just slips through my fucking fingers. I can't take it anymore. I'm done. I'm fucking done. I don't care anymore. Luckily, there are just 5 more shows to go. I end this stupid goddamn nightmare of a podcast on the 5th. Or on the 10th, I mean. I'm sorry, on the 10th. I end this stupid goddamn nightmare of a fucking whack job of a... Every day I go to bed exhausted. Every morning I wake up exhausted. I can't do this anymore. Go to bed exhausted. I wake up exhausted. I hate my life right now. I wanted to stay with podcasting, but unfortunately, that is not meant to be.
wanted was for the nightmare that has become my life to come to an end. Just completely dead stop. But no. No one can ever possibly fucking allow that. Fuck my life all to hell. You know? Fuck me and my life. Fuck being psychic. I don't fucking care no more. I'm done being psychic. I don't care. I don't want it anymore. I don't like it. I don't need it. But I'm not getting any 9-to-5 job. That will have to be... I'll have to be drug out of my trailer by my braids at gunpoint with a gun to my temple. Drug out of here. Forced into a business at gunpoint and forced at gunpoint to fill out an application. Yeah, that's the way it'll have to be. And fuck you if you think you're gonna cut my braids off. You know? Fuck my life all to hell. Fuck it. Just fuck it all. I don't care no more. Yeah, I threw the windscreen across the room. I don't even care. It wouldn't cooperate with me anyway, so fuck it. I'm so fucking sick and tired of this shit. I just don't care anymore. I don't care. No, I don't. I just don't care anymore. I'm done. I'm through caring. I'm over caring. Caring is what got me in trouble in the first place, and caring is the one thing I'm going to stop doing. I'm going to turn dark, evil, negative, and black-hearted. I guess my cousin's right. Maybe I am evil. You know? But hey, I have to be evil in order to fight evil. So there you have it. I just don't care about being evil anymore. I don't care. Maybe I am. I'm just sick and tired of my life, you know? I'm tired of it. I don't even care anymore. I'm done. I'm over it. Enough is enough, you know? Enough is fucking enough. And no, nothing and no one will ever make me feel any better. No one. God. Why me? Why even me? I don't even care. I don't even care anymore. No, I don't care. Caring is what got me in trouble in the first place. That's the truth. Being nice, being caring, being loving, being kind, that, you know, hang on, I gotta call communion. Hello, I'm on air.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll call you back.
Okay, we'll do.
Uh-huh, bye. Sorry about that. Anyway, enough is enough, you know? I'm done. I don't even care anymore. I don't care about anyone or anything anymore. I just don't. I can't. I won't. I refuse. I refuse, 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 refuse to be kind, to be caring, to be loving, to be honest, to be truthful, to be anything. I refuse it all now. I don't even care anymore. I just don't care. Caring is what got me in trouble, so therefore I'm going to stop doing that. Yeah. True. I'm going to stop doing all of that. Hang on, I got to get a drink of water. Sorry about that. I just had to grab a drink of water. I was getting a little dry. It's just, I'm at the end of my leash with my life. I don't want to care anymore. I really don't. also one other little thing, I guess, on the good side of all of this is, you know, no matter how bad things have gotten, my social following seems to be growing with each passing day. So that, I guess, in a way, is kind of a good thing. I'm just very, very tired a lot of the time. And growing more and more despondent with each day that passes because there's no justice. There's no justice for anything I've been dealing with. Maybe eventually there will be, but right now, at the moment, there is not. I'm just not happy with the way things have been going. My life has become a living, hellish nightmare. And I mean that seriously. And everything that I touch falls just right through my fingers. But the only thing right now that is kind of holding me steady is the fact being that, you know, that my business right now is insured. Yes, it is actually fully legally insured. And also, it is copyrighted as of this minute, as of this moment, or at least I'm waiting on the copyright to go through, and I'm also waiting on the trademark to go through as well. It's not there all the way yet, but it's working its way through the system. I have to make a couple final adjustments on those, or at least on one of them. That does make me feel a little bit better, I guess, in a way. But I'm not fully feeling all the way better yet because of a lot of the stress that continues and, I'm tired. I don't want really to have the ability I have anymore. I don't want it. But I'm also not going to abandon it either because, you know, I'm just getting started and I kind of want to keep on going for the moment. I just don't know anymore. I don't know how to feel about anything anymore. My soul has been shattered into a million different pieces because of a lot of infighting over the stalking mess and a lot of the crap that I'm dealing with trying to get through this and being called names and being told, oh, you're fake this and you're fake that, just because, you know, I have to continue to put up with what I got put up with. And that's not fair to me, you know? It's not fair to me, it's not fair to my heart, it's not fair to my soul. You know, how else can I say it? That's not fair to me or to my soul. It sucks. It just seriously sucks. I don't know what more to think. Having to continually put up with the lies and the bullshit and the name calling and the, you know, and all the lies against me and, whether it's at home or via the stalking mess or, you know, being accused of doing this to myself when that, in fact, is not true. All I can ask is why. Is it because I became too popular and too good too fast? Is that it? Is it because I became too popular, too big, too fast, and that I was too good at what I did at one point, and now I'm not as good as I used to be? I wish I were as good as I used to be. I really do. I truly and honestly, sincerely wish that I were as good as I used to be. Really and truly. It hurts to have to be dealing with a lot of bullshit, you know, both at home and at work, I guess, if you will. All the lies and all the, you know, name calling and the hurtful behavior and everything. And it's not so much the name calling that hurts me as it is those who are so willing to destroy my reputation at all cost that they would actually physically seek to harm my business. I have not sought to harm anybody's anything. Everyone tricked me, lied to me, abused me, harassed me, stalked me, threatened me. Everyone else did this to me, not me to anyone else. So people can quit projecting their shit onto me that never happened. I'm so angry and so hurting right now, I'm actually shaking. Believe it or not, I'm actually shaking and hurting so bad right now. My heart and my soul and my being are shattered into a million tiny pieces, and I don't know how I'm going to pick up the pieces and move forward again. I just don't know. But I guess I have the solace of knowing that my business and I are solid and legal, and it is all mine for as long as I need it to be. I hold the copyright, I hold the trademark, I hold the legal rights, and I hold what is mine. I hold the insurance. I hold, you know, I mean, this is mine now. Umpqua Valley Psychic and Media, The Outlaw Psychic, LLC in Roseburg, Oregon, is fully and completely legal. Mine. I own it. I hold it. Business license, EIN, LLC, trademark, copyright, and insurance. All mine. And no, I did not waste my money on it, regardless of whether or not I appreciate my own abilities. That don't mean jack shit. Do you understand me? It don't mean jack shit. I own the copyrights. I hold the trademark. I hold the insurance. All of it. It's mine. And no one can take it away from me now. No one. And I can prove that to every bit of every extent. I can prove what is mine is mine. I don't care what anyone's got to say about it. This business is now legally and completely mine. I'm not sharing it with nobody. This is mine, all mine. I did it. I invested my own money, my own time, my own work, my own everything. It's all mine. And there ain't nothing nobody can do about it. It is all mine. Ain't nothing nobody can do about it. No matter how many threats I get against it, no matter who does what against me, it's mine. You can't take it from me now. Not at all. I did it all, and I did it myself. I'm proud of that which I hold dear. I'm just sad because, you know, no matter what I do, I'm called things outside my name, outside my legal name, that do not belong to me. That I refuse, I reject, I deflect, and I dispute in full. I dispute it all. But one thing is, you can never, never, never take from me again. No one can. No one can take my radio programming. No one can take my legality. No one can take any of this from me again. No one. Put it down, maybe, but take it, no. This work is mine, now and forevermore. Regardless of how many things I am called outside of my name, outside my legal name, my legal name is Melissa Bryan. Use it or lose it. Point blank, period. And come July, this is how my life will go. Please take a listen.
Through your days, got your head hung low, your sky's a shade of gray, like a zombie in a maze. You're asleep inside, but you can shake awake, cause you're just a dead man walking, thinking that's your only option. But you can flip the switch and brighten up your darkest day. Sun is up and the color's blinding, take a world and redefine it. Leave behind your narrow mind, you'll never be the same. Come alive, come alive, go and light your light, let it burn so bright, reach it up to the sky, and it's open wide, your electrified. And the world becomes a fantasy, and you're more than you could ever be, cause you're dreaming with your eyes wide open. And you know you can't go back again to the world that you were living in, cause you're dreaming with your eyes wide open. So come alive. I see it in your eyes. Afraid to step outside, so you lock the door, but don't you stay that way.
Some are living in those shadows, you and me, we don't have that ghost.
Cause once you see it, oh, you'll never, never be the same.
Little bit of life is dragging,
now, this is also where I plan to go with this, and what I am doing is giving my own battle cry of freedom. And this
got
is how I feel.
For an invention,
hang on.
But don't know what to do next? Call my friends at InventHelp. It's
our flag is proudly floating on the land and on the main. Shout, shout the battle cry of freedom. Beneath it oft we've conquered and will conquer oft again. Shout, shout the battle cry of freedom. Our Dixie forever, she's never had a loss. Shout the battle cry of freedom. Our gallant boys have marched to the rolling of the drums. Shout, shout the battle cry of freedom. And the leaders in charge cry out, come, boys, come. Shout, shout the battle cry of freedom. Shout the battle cry of freedom. They have laid down their lives on the bloody battlefield. Shout, shout the battle cry of freedom. Their motto is resistance to the tyrants never yield. Shout, shout the battle cry of freedom.
My battle cry of freedom. Freedom from hate, freedom from abuse, freedom from threats, freedom from lies, freedom from abuse, freedom from all of it that I've been fighting and fighting and fighting some more. And unfortunately, I may have to continue to fight on a little bit longer, but justice will eventually come my way. I know it will. It has to. So with that, I will be ending this show in a short moment or two. I have 4 minutes 26 on the clock, and thank you, Spreaker, for the 5-minute warning. So basically, this is my new show with my new boom mic. Who knows? Maybe, just maybe, I might go on to do another show. I don't know if this will be at a professional studio. I don't know if this will be personally in my home. I just don't know yet. I don't know what's going to happen, and I don't know how far that's going to go. But so far, I love the way that this boom mic is working to make this show really sound good. And so, I thank y'all all for listening, and I'll be back tomorrow with another show. Again, my show ends on June 10. I'm going to be stepping away from the microphone, because I want to pursue other interests. There are other things I want to do, and I'm getting tired of fighting over my rights and my life and my way and my everything. I'm tired of fighting over it. I'm done. I'm done. No, seriously, I'm done. I'm not going to fight people over this anymore, and If I'm going to do this again, I think I'd rather do it in a professional studio, because then I have someone on the other end controlling not only just sound and mics, but also controlling callers and what information comes through, and can cut it off if things get too bad. So that's the way I'm allowing this to roll now. You know, y'all can just get used to it. I don't care anymore. No, I'm done caring. I'm over caring. I'm through caring. Caring is not something you're going to remember about me anymore. Yeah, no, caring is not something you're going to remember about me anymore. Because that's just the way it goes. And sometime next year, I may, for videos, go with Vimeo and not go with YouTube anymore. You know, do my shows on something that allows me a more professional slant on things. And I do want to get another tripod so that I can maybe put this show on video. I think that would be a really cool thing to do. Anyway, this is Melissa Bryan, the one, only, and original Outlaw Psychic from Umpqua Valley Psychic and Media, The Outlaw Psychic, LLC, in Roseburg, Oregon. Thank you all for listening, and the show ends at a minute 29 to put this show to bed. Bye-bye.